All right. Favorite song? Well, let's check your bench. I'm sorry. Let's check the bench here. So, you're gonna. What I want you to start thinking about now are two things. First of all, is if you're far enough from away from it, you're like this. So you can stretch your arms out straight, and you touch. So see, you're a little too far away. So I need to scoot you up just a little bit. That's just for the distance, not that I want you to start playing that way. Okay? It's just to make sure you're the right distance. There you go. There you go. And then the other thing is...
You have to lean a little back if...
Just your back is straight. Mm-hmm, just to see. And then turn your hands over like this, like you're holding two very nice-sized bubbles in your hands. Mm-hmm. Then you can turn those over and float your hand on to wherever you want to start. Thank you.
Well, I don't really have a favorite song.
Okay, well, what would you like to start with?
Who's that?
Okay. So we have your bubbles in those hands. The new song.
Jingle Bells.
Oh, is Jingle Bells the new song? Or was that our new song last week?
New song last week.
Okay, so our new song is in book three. Book three. Try to look a little happier about that. Smile or something. You are entering book three. That's right. So our new song is in book three. So, and you might even know the song, I don't know. So I'll sing it first. If you know it, you can sing along. Are you sleeping? Are you sleeping? Brother John, morning bells are ringing. Morning bells are ringing. Ding, dong, dong. Ding, dong, ding. You can do it either way.
I have to do ding, dang, dong.
That's fine.
I know it in French. All three of them.
Great. Well, you can sing it whichever one you want. Would you tap as you sing? In French?
Frère Jacques. I get mixed up with the songs because it's close to the one.
Dwemi pronto?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Sometimes it sounds like the same language, but
okay.
It's not.
Okay, let's do it in English first so we can go through our tapping here. And then then you can do it in French if you want to. Here you go.
Are you sleeping? Are you sleeping? Brother John. Morning bells are ringing. Ding, ding, dong. Ding, ding, dong.
Oh, great. Okay, now let's do French.
I guess that just shows... It's a step away.
Well, it's farther than a step. It's ding. It's pretty far down. Ding, ding, dong. A big skip, actually. A big skip. So how many times did you do each line when you were tapping?
Two times.
When you do two times, we're going to put a repeat sign, two bars and two dots to show that you're going to do it two times. Would you put that for the other lines?
Like that.
Got it.
So I guess if you do three lines, it means you're playing it three times.
You know, that makes a lot of sense to do it that way, but actually if you do it three times, you just write three times. That would make a lot of sense though to have three bars for that.
Yeah. Then if you play one part three times, what do you do?
You write three times at the bottom to let the person know that you're doing it three times.
Oh.
I know, that's not very interesting, is it? All right, let's tap on it one more time and we'll sing the French. Here we go. Frère Jacques, Frère Jacques, dormez-vous, sonnent les matines, ding-ding-dong, ding-ding-dong. Thank you. So would you tap on that this week for your new song? Mm-hmm. Awesome. All right. Also, would you just keep tapping on Jolly Old St. Nicholas and Jingle Bells?
Okay.
You feel good about those two?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. Let's go to Lavender's Blue.
Lavender's blue, dilly dilly, lavender's green. When I am king, dilly dilly, you shall be queen with the contour. Lavender's blue, dilly dilly, lavender's green. When
thank you very much. Okay, come on down here to the bells.
Minus is that's five or six places.
That's a really good guess. And we're going to find out for sure right now. Let's just do the first little part. Here we go.
Lavender's blue, dilly dilly.
Okay, so how many was that? You can figure that out. Let's check it.
One, two, ooh, ooh, three, four,
five.
Five different sounds, that's right. Okay, now lavender's green.
Lavender's green.
And I need one more, so six.
Good for you. Okay, I think that's enough.
Oops.
Two. I can get these guys over here. Let me see. This way, right? This way? Is this okay?
Okay.
And would you sing one, please?
Lavender's blue.
Exactly how you should figure it out. So, would you play it again now a couple more times now that you kind of figured it out? bells this week?
Eight.
Great. Can I hear a twinkle on the bells now? Twinkle, twinkle. So Lavender's Blue is going to be on the bells. Okay. And would you play that four times every day on the bells, Lavender's Blue?
Okay.
Thank you. Okay. Let's see about Twinkle here. So you can go over to the Twinkling Twinkles. And our hand position is going to be like a little bit tricky.
For Twinkle?
Mm-hmm. So your left hand is pretty much not playing, except it has to cross over. So you're going to be right here, and I'll show you. We go twinkle, twinkle. Oh, sorry. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. So your left hand's pretty much just sitting on your lap other than that. Your right hand's right on here. Let's try that.
It seems like it would be easier with this and this, but we play it the different way.
Well, there's a lot of fingers. That's why we are doing it that way. So we need your thumb on there. Thumb on C. Here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go. Okay. And you can scoot your body over this way if you need to, so your hand's a little more comfortable. And so this is the first one where we had our hand like this. So it'll be a little bit weird at first. Okay? But I ask you to just try it anyway. Even though your thumb's going to want to fall off a lot, try to keep putting it back on there.
Okay?
Let's try it. Twinkle, twinkle,
twinkle, twinkle.
And then take finger two.
This one?
That's right, that's right.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
Mm-hmm.
How I. It's kind of hard to play.
Yes, it is. Like, it is. Sound That's is. What I know. So just try to grab those keys the best you can.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I want.
If you can curve your hand more, it'll be easier. How I really grab that key. Grab it instead of it being flat right there. Grab that key. There you go. Grip that key. Yeah. How I. Can you start right there? How I. Mm-hmm. That's going to be kind of hard.
Okay.
But don't worry. Just keep trying it. Okay?
Okay.
It might not be easy this week, but I'd like you to just play it four times each day.
Okay.
Okay? All right. So you understand about that? You're good with that? Can I hear it one more time now since you found that hand position? One more time?
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder.
bit better about it? Okay. Can I hear hot cross buns, please?
On black or white?
Your choice. We have in hot cross buns there?
Three
sounds. Are they steps apart or skips apart?
Steps.
Just steps apart. This one you know as me, right? And after me, then we have re, which looks like this with your hand sign. Re, say re.
Re.
Uh-huh. Just like half of an X, like if you were making an X with your hand. And then do is do. A fist. Good.
And this is do.
You've got
like,
it.
Like this is la.
Me. Well, la sound is up here. This is mi, re, do. Uh-huh. So would you sing that with me with your hand sign? Let's try the hand signs.
So no. That's like for hot cross buns.
Right. So we're going to do hot cross buns with our mi, re, do's. Okay. Let's try it.
Mi, re, do.
Very good. Let's do it again. Great. Now, would you sing that while you're playing that part of Hot Cross Buns? We've got Ray here in the middle. Because that's still do. Go ahead. Okay, good. So Ray is the one in the middle.
So for that, for right back to same, I'm playing it like that.
Would you play it and try to sing the mi, re, do's?
Okay.
Okay. Now, can we also try that with closet key? So would you play closet key first and sing the words? Let's do it in the same spot for now.
Wait, closet key's in this spot?
Can we do it there, please? I have lost the...
I have...
Right. Now I'm going to sing part of the closet key. Would you try to sing back the do's or mi's or re's?
I have lost the closet key.
Your turn. Do, do.
Do, do, mi, mi.
Right, because remember on here, play that part again on the piano. I have lost that. Just play that part.
I have lost.
Yes, now, Key, you can leave your hand there. You see how you played do and you played mi, but we skipped over re.
Uh-huh.
You see that? So that's why we skipped it in our singing, too. Okay, can we sing it again, do's and mi's?
Uh-huh. Do, do.
Do the whole song, but if you can do part of it on the do's and mi's for this week.
Okay.
If you can do the whole song, great, but if it starts to get confusing to you, just try to do part of the song.
Okay.
So I'm going to sing to you some words from Closet Key. Would you play and sing the do's and mi's back to me?
I have lost the closet key.
What are the names here?
Do.
This do. This mi.
Next part. knees here. Right. Yeah, so that's, so again, it's brand new. We just started it, so don't be worried about it. Just try to do it a little bit this week, okay? All right, so a little bit with the does and the me's. Okay, and you are good to go. So hot cross buns, frog in the meadow, or closet key, just one a day with a little bit with the me-re-dos. A little me-re-do. Okay? All right, just try it. Okay, I'm going to put this in volume 2. Oops, sorry. Okay, so just for a couple weeks while we're doing these mi-re-dos, would you bring all three? And then as soon as we finish the mi-re-dos, because we're going to write out the mi-re-dos in this one, in book 1,
okay.
Then you can just bring 2 and 3. So for now, got to bring all 3.
Okay.
Okay, there you go. Very nice. Have a good class, okay?
Okay. So next time, I always bring this too.